Hashem, Hashem, Naseh, Benasteach. We continue with Pele Yoes on subject of Dibur, power of speech. So this is part 5. Ubezdechirat ma'ashayasu palak. So this one we did. Ubezdechirat ma'ase Miriam haneviya nichlal lischol restapet tochacha al avon. And also the mitzvah of remembering what Miriam haneviya did, that he spoke lashon hara of Moshe Rabbeinu, and that was the Avon, and that required tochacha and rebuke on that, and the teshuvah that she made. Ki rabim machovim l'rasha leman yirdu panim, that there are many ways that a person could become a rasha, right? But when a person rebukes himself or herself, then that could save his children, and it could take away that bad influence. ובזכירת ירושלים נכלל לזחול ולספר כמה וכמה שער השמיים ושער כל העולמות אנו גורמים בעוונותינו. And also we need to remember that we don't have the Beit HaMikdash, and the Yerushalayim is not built yet, even though that people are living there now, even though that there is lots of buildings going on over there, yeshivot are flourishing, and there is so much going on, but it's not in its fullest glory, and there is lots of more potentials to come. There is lots of potentials there. Vesa'ar, and therefore that is causing sufferings to everyone, and especially HaKadosh Baruch Hu, because of our sins, we don't have the Beit HaMikdash built, and the Yerushalayim is not built yet. As you see in the news, always argue about it. When Mashiach comes, then there won't be any more argument. We'll have Yerushalayim fully for our services to Hashem. Ze hakelal, this is the rule. Kol hamedabe davar shegolem le'ira o le'avayet Hashem. Any speech that is given and it causes fear of Hashem, it increases the fear of Hashem or the love of Hashem. Ve'lishmor kol davar tov ve'limshoch yado ma'asot kol ra'ah. And it's in accordance to doing good things, and helps a person to stay away from bad things. Velashuv v'teshuvah, and helps a person to make teshuvah, repentance, and return to Hashem. Vekadome, and things of similar. Mitzvah ka'aved, that is considered a established mitzvah, and one should continue on that usage of speech. Ubilvah sheichaven libo l'shamayim. However, that requires a person have in mind that I'm using the power of speech, right, for the mitzvah of Ahavat Hashem, Yirat Shamayim, and so forth. Ubaze yedaberu yirei Hashem behiyotam bechevrat anashim. And therefore those who fear Hashem, they speak in the groups. Veifarreshu sechokatam lelamed da'at et ha'am hatu'elet hayose me'otam hadevarim, and they stay away from those who make laughters and they just, you know, talk in vain, no constructive speech, and they stay away from those groups. Ubaze yihye siach siftotam chashuv, and therefore what they say, all their speech becomes important. Omekubal, and is accepted by people, is accepted by Hashem. Omeruse kechol hayose, and what they pray for, it's going to, what comes out from their mouth is going to happen. Okefi hatoelet hanimshach mimenu kacha yerase, and because of this toelet, all the good things that it comes out of this is going to happen, and that will be the rason of Hashem. So because they watch their speech, they don't just talk in vain. Mitzvah levarech et Hashem birchot hanenin. There is another mitzvah of using our speech to say blessings to Hashem. O birchot hamitzvot. Birchot hanenim are the things that we enjoy, like aseh, ispeh, mineh v'samim. When you eat something, you know, there's enjoyment involved, and you make bracha on that. So there's a mitzvah to say blessings on those things. Ubirchot mitzvot. Now, what is the birchot mitzvot? Let's, if a person makes beracha on netilat lulav, when a person makes a bracha on saying Birkat Torah, that's called.
Vehaodaot venachat ubekod ram, and praising Hashem should be done benachat. Benachat means slowly, right? Bekod ram, and out loud. And in other words, when you praise Hashem in a good way, clear, right? Loud, like don't whisper. If you could praise Hashem in groups, that's even bigger mitzvah. As they say, Berov Hatnat Melech, that a person should glorify Hashem in a bigger groups, bigger minyanim. Therefore, it's a mitzvah to go to places daven with bigger minyanim, right? Ube kavana, and with intention, right intentions, ube simchat halev, and this is perhaps very important, with simcha, with happiness that comes from your heart, the simchat chaim, right? What's that?
Pure love.
Pure love, yeah, exactly. Pure love for Hashem. Misva al hakohanim levarechet Israel. Another category of using power of speech is for kohanim to give blessing to Yehudim. Vegam no'alu otam hakohanim shiyus'im lezat betakneset kede shelo levarech bikat kohanim umabdim tova harbe. And we need to inform Uma Gualo Otam. We need to inform those Kohanim. Those Kohanim who, you know, they leave they leave the Beit HaKnesset in order not to give Birkat Kohanim. What they do is not good. Apparently, there were some Kohanim that didn't want to give blessing and they would leave B'Sha'at Birkat Kohanim. They would not be present in the shul, right? Why are you doing that? You know, if you are a kohen, you are mechuyav, you are obligated to praise Yehudim, to give them Birkat Kohanim. From Birkat Kohanim, the blessing of Hashem comes through Am Israel, right? Umavedim ota shelosha asayan uliyot mevurachim mipi hakodosh baruch hu. So there are three people who enjoy from this. One, the Kohen who gives Birkat Kohanim. One, the Yehudi who receives it. And one, Hashem. Why? Because through Birkat Kohanim, the blessing of Hashem comes to Am Israel. Right? As it says in Parashat Bamidbar, Vesamu et Shemi ad Bnei Israel, and place my name on Bnei Israel, Vani Avarechem, and then I'll come and bless them. וטוב בעיני השם שכל אדם יברך את ישראל, and it's appealing and is good in the eyes of Hashem, as if to say Hashem has no eyes, but in our understanding that when Hashem sees a Yehudi gives blessing to another Yehudi, therefore it's very good always to give blessings to each other. And when we say Shalom, that's a blessing by itself, right? That may be peace on you.
So what was the reason that the Kohanim didn't?
Well, maybe they didn't. There were some Kohanim that had sinat chinam. In fact, the halacha is that if there is a Kohen that has some sort of disagreement with somebody in the kehal, he's not allowed to go to Dukhan unless he forgives that person. Because bracha comes from pure love. Bracha comes with ahava. If there is no ahava, if there is sinat lo aleinu, if there is, you know, hatred, then the blessing would not come fully, right? And whoever gives blessing, he is blessed. Kedichtiv, as the pasuk says in Bereshit, that Hashem told Avraham Avinu, those who bless you are blessed, and I bless them. ומה גם לצדיקים שתחף שמזכירים חייב לברכם כדכתיב זכר צדיק ברכה. And those צדיקים who passed away, also we need to bless them by saying זסל or זכר צדיק ברכה or עליו השלום. והנה כי כן צריך להיזהר כשמזכיר לאברהם אבינו. Therefore, one needs to be very careful when he mentions our forefather Abraham Avinu. all Ishar Saddiqim and Hasidim, or other Saddiqim or pious people, di bechol dor va dor sheyomar, that they lived in every generation, that we need to say Allah va shalom. That we need to, when we say the name Abraham Avinu, Allah va shalom. Moshe Rabbeinu, Allah va shalom. Or Zichrono Livracha.
May his memory be a blessing.
Or Lizchol Lachaye Haolam Abba. Or that he should be Zocha, he should be
merit
to get to the Chaye Olam Abba, to the everlasting life in the world to come. Ule Misva Techashev, and there's a Misva to think. Veti Hani Shelora Iti Nohagim Lizaer Baskarat Shem. So we need to think that when we mention the name of the Amoraim, the times of Gemara, those Chachamim were in the times of Mishnah Tanaim, or all those Sadiqim before us, that when we mention the names, right, the names of the Acharonim, also Ben Bichteva, Ben Be'amira, whether it is we're reading it, we just mention the name Nizharim Techef Lomar, that we be careful to say Zichro L'Chaya Olam Haba, that may they merit to live in the Olam Haba. O Zeche Sadiq V'Kadosh Livracha, that may the memory of a Sadiq and a Kadosh Livracha be blessed, a holy Sadiq. Ulefi Hanir'eh Haya Ra'uy, and because of this, it appears that is appropriate. Ra'uy Yoter Lizaher, that a person needs to be very careful, like a Dushim Hakadmonim, of the very holy individuals that lived in a previous generation. Asher Qatanam Ava Mimitane Hacharunim Lakayem Bahem Kara Kitiv Zechesar Racha Dehainu Levarecho or Lesapero Bishvacho. That they were less than other Chassadikim, but they were Acharonim. They also are fit to get the title of Zechesar Racha. Or that we give. And when we talk about them, we give beracha to their memory, or speak with lots of kavod. So this concludes part five. Bezashem, we continue. Baruch Adonai Leolam. Amen. Amen.